be together. And the criminology we have studied to some extent why criminology is required. Suppose a crime has been committed, a criminal has committed, do you leave him there? Okay, under him, honor killing, the father killed son-in-law. Of course, the case is going on still. Very heinous, you know, when his daughter is pregnant. Yes, yes, yes. She is, trial is going on. You discuss very heinous things. Like that only. But one thing, here, what is the criminology? That means, criminal means of punishment, already in study of the subject of avoiding punishment. What is the requirement of punishment? Is required? Do you suggest to give punishment to the criminal? Father killed son-in-law. Father only killed son-in-law. Nobody would say. The father of the wife only killed. So let him go. Let the son-in-law die. Let the girl marry another girl, another man. As for the wishes of the father, do you accept?
No, sir.
But father only? That means you don't want to exempt the father? What is this? Suppose A killed B, that is a different issue. A asked to the girlfriend, wife, B, you allow me and marry. No, I don't know. Okay, that is different. You can kill her. You can kill her. Okay, but when father killed the son-in-law, that too, when his daughter is already pregnant with son-in-law. Do we expect to give punishment to him? Because there is no discrimination to avoid punishment as a father, mother, wife. So that is the concept of the criminology. There is no discrimination based on caste, creed, sex, or because of the as per the constitution. Therefore, the concept of the criminology. When a crime has been committed, the criminal law operates irrespective of the caste, creed, color, that rich or poor, with reference to the preamble of our constitutional law.